time for Money Matters. Joining us today is Josh Smith from Strategic Wealth Designers with some advice on building an emergency fund. So Josh, who needs an emergency fund, that safety net?
Yeah, so I think everyone needs an emergency fund or that safety net. The world can turn very quickly. You want to make sure you have access to cash or capital really quickly, just in the event that you would need it if something unexpected were to happen.
It can be daunting to try and, you know, think about saving up some extra money when we're all stretched so thin, but what's your best advice to get started?
Well, I think it really depends on where you are in life. For those younger folks, I would always abide by what's called the 70-20-10 rule. So no more than 70% of your income for living expenses, no more than 20% for debt, and then 10% or more for savings and retirement savings, your 401k and the emergency funds, those types of things. If you're in the middle of the road, say someone like myself, 30, 40s, 50s, raising a family, you know, you want to have that emergency fund 3 to 6 months. If you're already in retirement or about ready to retire, you definitely want to have 6 months or more saved up.
And then finally, you mentioned retirement. So why is it so important to start saving early for that?
Well, if you think about it, you know, you want compound interest working for you long term. That's really the name of the game to really grow your retirement funds long term, is to have that compounding effect of the growth of your money long time. That's gonna help you a lot more in the long run. So it, you know, reminds me of an ode, I don't know if it's a proverb, maybe you've heard something similar, that someone is in the shade today because someone else planted a tree 20 years ago, or something to the effect of, you know, the best time to start savings was 20 years ago, the next best time is today.
Makes sense. Josh, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For more tips to make your money matter, visit our website, WKYT.com. If there's something you'd like us to discuss, send your request to news@WKYT.com, and we'll talk about it here.